Lighthouse Christian Academy. The world has changed much since 1974. Richard Nixon was president. A postage stamp cost a dime. AMC introduced the Rimmel car that many of you don't even know what I'm talking about. A brand new one that cost $2,800. The world has changed much since that time. And Lighthouse Christian Academy has changed in many ways since that time. But what has not changed is our love for God, His Word, the truth, and holiness that we did believe, that we do believe, and that with God's help we will continue to believe into the future. And we welcome you this evening to this time of celebration and fellowship with some of the greatest people in all the world. Let's pray together right now and ask God to speak to us this evening and to bless this service. God, we love you. Thank you that we gather tonight in the United States of America, a country with great freedom that we don't deserve. And we know that freedom is not America's gift to the world, but it's God's gift to all mankind everywhere. We thank you that we have this opportunity to assemble tonight. We thank you for those in harm's way even tonight, fighting for the freedom that we too often take for granted. Thank you for the sacrifice of so many parents, grandparents, friends, relatives, teachers, faculty, and others that have made what we're celebrating tonight possible. We ask that you would bless each graduate, bless them abundantly, keep them, lead God, and direct them to the next phase of their education and throughout their lives. We'll give you all the praise and the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. And everyone say amen.
Amen.
Please remain standing for our national anthem and pledges. And yes, we do stand for the national anthem.
Me being on Mary's team, I think it's about 12 years now,
And the journey's not always been good, but to me it's been worth every minute of it to see the accomplishment in what Mary has done. And it's all because of God's help that He's helped us. And I also want to thank Brother Shield for picking me to be the one to work with Mary Madison and all the staff, all the teachers that's helped us when we needed it. We really appreciate it, and we want to say thank you tonight. And so it's my honor to be Mary's voice tonight as I help her speech. First of all, thank you for coming tonight. It has been an honor to attend Christian school and be able to be a part of the great group of students and friends, as well as my teacher and the LCA staff. I am grateful that everyone is here tonight, and I'm looking forward to the next 4 years at LCA. For the English, I want to say thank you. I want to say that I am sorry for not always making it through Bible class without a nap, but thank you for the text and being a great teacher. Thanks to all for being here and celebrating this night with me. Thank you.
For a moment, Mary Madison is a sweet young lady. She doesn't need anybody to be her mind. She has a very bright mind. She doesn't need anybody to be her energy. She's got more energy than probably anybody in the room tonight. She doesn't need anybody to be her attitude, because she can have any kind of attitude that she wants to, anytime she wants to. But she does have a need for someone to be her voice. And we are so honored and appreciative that Sister LaVonna Edgen has taken time all these years to faithfully, in good times and tough times, be a voice. And we believe and hope and pray that Mary Madison, 4 years from tonight, stands here behind this desk and fluently delivers her own speech. We hope that she goes to college from there and travels the world talking about a miracle that God had given her. And we believe that's possible. Let me say that again. We do believe that's possible. But what's more important than anything that I just mentioned is that we have every expectation and belief that she's headed to a city where she will talk. And we have every expectation and belief for God that one day we'll go there and we'll hear her. Hopefully not for the first time, but if it's there, I don't want to miss heaven for a variety of reasons, but one is I want Mary Madison Moxley to tell me just exactly what she thinks. We love her and her family. Her dad has a presentation to make tonight.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for being here tonight. It's a privilege to get to see Mary Madison up here. Glad she's doing well. Things are better. We wanted to take this opportunity tonight present something to an amazing lady, somebody who spent the last 10 years really making a difference in somebody's life. You know, I got to thinking about that. What do we do on a daily basis that really changes somebody's life? What efforts do you put forth? Do you help somebody when they're down? Do you help somebody in a financial struggle? Do you help somebody get introduced, you know, to the spiritual presence that they need in their life? Well, that's something I think we can all pay a little more attention to. And I wanted to recognize her tonight because she is a very compassionate lady. She's got an unbelievable heart and dedication. She's been there through the tough times. She's been a part of the whole journey since we started school here. It's been an amazing thing for us to be able to be a part of a Christian school and this environment. I know we've been through a lot of different trials and things, but I think to her point, she said it as good as anybody could. The reward's worth it. You know, we're glad to share her as a part of our extended family, and just can never thank her with enough words of the difference she's made in Mary Madison's life and our family's life. And we're looking forward to those miracles that the pastor talks about. We're not giving up on those by any stretch of the imagination. And I believe you see one tonight, Mary being able to be here on this platform after the things that she's been through over the last 45 days. So we'll just count that as miracle one with many more to follow. And at this time, I just want to present Sister LaDonna with a token of appreciation from the Lighthouse Christian Academy. Also, great recognition on behalf of our family for all that she does on a day-to-day basis and her dedication and her compassion, love, and her being willing to help and assist others. Sister LaDonna.
Moxley. spectacular. This one is the same age, believe it or not, but big in stature. First kindergarten diploma goes to Boston Bradley. String. Thank you.
friends. Welcome to Lighthouse Christian Academy Ceremony of 2018. Thank you everyone for coming tonight. I am sending out a big thank you to my parents, Mark and Winona White, for the sacrifices they have made, making it possible for me to attend Lighthouse Christian Academy for the past 5 years. Thank you, Mom, for helping me with my speech. I give a great appreciation to my bishop, Dr. John Shield, and Sister Shield for their burden to attend. For their burden to start Christian school. If it wasn't for God giving them a burden, I wouldn't have had a wonderful experience I've had at Lighthouse Christian Academy. I would like to personally thank the First Lady, Sister Shield, for all she has done for me. Thank you, Pastor Jason and Sister Violet, for preaching the truth and being an example our young people can look up to. Thank you to Sister Peggy, Sister Carmen, and Sister Leslie for the dedication and hard work they have unselfishly given to me. In closing, I'm looking forward with a positive outlook to the next 40 years that are ahead of me. Attending my 8th grade graduation. I've been so blessed to be able to attend Lighthouse Christian Academy. It's a very special day for me because it's where I move out of the 8th grade and into high school. I know it will always be easy, but I'm ready to give it my best shot. First of all, I would like to thank Bishop Shield and Sister Shield for having a burden for Christian education and starting LCA. Thank you, Pastor Jason and Sister Violet, for carrying the torch. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for the sacrifice of sending me to attend LCA. And thanks to my grandma for driving me every day. I was so blessed to have my grandpa as my amazing Bible teacher. Thank you to all my former teachers who helped me begin this journey, and thank you to Sister Janice who taught me the basics and set the foundation for my education. These past years have helped me prepare for the next 4 years that lie ahead. While at LCA, I have learned many things. One of the most important things I have learned is that in life, you have to step out of your comfort zone and take action. But with God's help, He will guide you through all your tests and trials. You may fall sometimes, but what's most important is you get back up and carry on. You only get to live once, so you need to make it count. On a final note, I'd like to congratulate both of the seniors and thank you for all the memories we have made together. I want to wish you the best as you go through the next phase of your life.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I appreciate all my family and friends for coming out to make this night special for me. I'd like to honor my mother and father for making it possible for me to have a Christian education. To Brother and Sister Shield for having a burden for the Christian school and for being great examples in my life. To all of my LCA teachers, thanks for all the help and encouragement you gave me to achieve all my goals in life. As I look at my past, I took and all the decisions I have made has helped me to realize who I am and who I want to be. I wanted not to follow footsteps, but to create my own. Eighth grade was a chance for me to shine once more. It was time to discover how to stand up for my own beliefs. I didn't let my fears of belonging prevent me from showing my true self. Finding myself amidst a sea has some of the decisions was tough lesson to learn, even harder still to gain. But sure enough, I have set my own goal not to let anyone discourage me. Eighth grade gave me a chance to learn to walk with confidence and live without holding back. I will never forget what I have learned within these school walls. I will never forget the chance I took. This is all major transformation I have all undergone to create together in this school can never be erased. And now I stand here awaiting what the future holds. As this chapter ends, I am more than ready to begin the next. I desire all your prayers that and prayers I make, the right decisions, and follow what God has for my future. Thank you, and God bless.
Environment, and because of the huge sacrifice of my parents and the grace of God,
I am standing before you in my best self. As most of you know, a year ago today, I made a decision that would overcome a setback that was made in my life. I was able to accomplish successfully 2 years in one, and for this, I am very proud. A big part of me being able to accomplish that is due to the help of Sister Carmen Chambers. Words could never tell the appreciation that I have for you. Thank you for all you've done for me. My next dedication will be to my very best friend, Catherine. Thank you for always being with me through hardships and trials. I will never forget the times we cried together, laughed together, and yelled at each other for something that wasn't even a big deal. I can't wait to see if our future holds the same things in store. Graduation is a time to reflect on the past and to look forward to the future. This is a time that we get to celebrate what we've accomplished and what we will look forward to accomplish in the future. Edward Knox said, "The fireworks begin today, and each diploma is a lighted match, and each one of you is a fuse. This is just the beginning."
You are mine.
graduation. Graduation is such an exciting time. It's both an ending, and more importantly, it's a beginning. It's a time for us to make our big dreams a reality. I would first like to thank the most amazing, kind, loving, and supportive person in this room, my mom. Mom, you're the best, and I love you. Next, I'd like to say thanks to someone for their support of my Christian education. Yes, Chuck, I'm thankful for you. Being an only child isn't all it's cracked up to be. Thank you for making my life interesting and constantly giving me someone to argue with. Thank you, Aunt Victoria, for being my personal chauffeur for the first half of my teens and for pretty much being my second mom. Grandma, thanks for being my go-to project person or simply just making me a cheese ball. Even though Grandpa is no longer here, I would like to thank him for always being there with a warm hug and always asking, how's my Katie bug? Brother and Sister Shield, thank you for your dedication and love for Christian education. Sister Carmen, thank you for being my very best teacher, even though to this day, I still do not understand shelf life. I appreciate your efforts though. Thank you to all LCA staff. One of my fondest memories at Lighthouse Christian Academy is a poem we recited for many years. I would like to share it with you all tonight. Follow your dream, take one step at a time. Don't settle for less, just continue to climb. Follow your dream, if you stumble, don't stop. Keep your eye on the goal, press on to the top. For only on top can we see the whole view, can we see what we've done and what we can do. Can we then have the vision to see something new? Press on and follow your dream. Dr. Oscar Underwood. Thank you to my friends. I would love to thank you all by name, but we do not have the time for that tonight. To you all, I say thank you for the memories, whether that be sweet or crazy. And let me tell you, the crazy outweighs the sweet. In every psalm in the Bible, when David pours out his heart through his grief, trials, and struggles, he concludes the psalm with praising God and giving him glory. I would like to conclude with giving the most important thank you. Thank you, Jesus, for all things. Praise your holy name.
I remember this. Not for me, but it was a long time ago. In fact, I'm going to my 48th reunion Saturday. So I know how exciting it is, but I really feel like I have a word from the Lord, and the song just confirmed it. In Hebrews 6, 18 and 19, it talks about we have hope as an anchor of the soul. I'm going to talk a little bit about an anchor. What is an anchor? It's usually made of metal, and it is used to prevent from drifting due to current or the strong wind. An anchor represents stability and strength to endure a safe end for a long journey. It's known as a sea brake. It's to stabilize in heavy weather, and it can be temporary or it can be permanent. In Acts the 27th chapter, we find a story told in the Word of God that there was a ship that was about to sail, and they were warned not to sail, to just keep their anchor down and stay. But they didn't listen because they thought it looked okay to travel. So we find that there was a very bad storm called Euroclydon. In that storm, the Bible tells us, they lost the ship, the cargo, and they would have lost their lives except for the preacher. And I want to talk to our girls tonight, our beautiful seniors, about making sure you have an anchor. Up until tonight, your families, your church family, your teachers, our bishop and our pastor, they've somewhat kept your anchors in place. But as you wake up in the morning, you're going to begin a journey all your own. It will involve decisions like, what do I do now? Where do I go from here? Is it a job? Is it college? What do I do? There's going to be many other intense decisions that you will make. It's your responsibility to drop your anchor. Not saying that everyone's going to back off and give it to you and just let you do whatever you think's best. But the final decision in your life is going to be up to you. We've seen many other graduates from this school. Some have gone on to make great decisions in college, and some have done other things, but you're going to be in charge of your own destiny. You may say, how can I do this and guide my ship safely? You must never forget to keep your anchor in place when you're deciding life's decisions. There's some different areas that you need to put your anchor down. You need to anchor yourself in the Word. You need to make sure that you learn the Scriptures. You've learned them in school. You've been taught in Sunday school. You've probably had Scripture readings at home. Don't stop now. You've got to put your anchor down in reading the Word of the Lord. If you don't put the Word in, it's never going to be there to come out. There's probably many people in this church tonight that can tell you that when facing decisions and storms and trials come, all of a sudden, out of nowhere, the Word of God will come and you will remember something that the Word of God has said. Another place you need to drop your anchor is worship. Don't ever forget who He is and that He deserves all of your praise. At all times, it doesn't matter if it's in the good or in the bad. And there will be good and there will be bad. Life happens to everyone. There's going to be happy times, there'll be sad, there'll be pain, and there'll be good health. Life has a way of bringing things that you don't even think can ever happen. But if you will worship God in everything,
The Lord spoke to me one time to worship Him, give Him thanks, and I said, Lord, how can I give You thanks for this? Because it is not Your will. And He immediately spoke to me and said, I didn't tell you to thank Me for it. I said, in everything, give thanks. So you must learn to give thanks. The third place you need to drop an anchor is holiness. It does not matter what current is pulling at you. There'll be a lot of currents that you're going to come in contact with, but you drop your anchor in holiness. It doesn't matter if your friends have a different point of view, if the people that you work with, holiness is still right. Holiness is still right. God's way is the only right way to make your safe haven, and that's heaven. The fourth place is in God's house. You need to drop your anchor in the house of God. Be faithful. Just because our lives change, we still need to be faithful to the house of God. If you lose your faithfulness in every area of your life, that's no matter what, if you lose your faithfulness, you'll lose your power. If you lose your power, you'll lose your holiness. And when you lose your holiness, you're going to lose your soul. Drop your anchor down in holiness, in God's house, in worship, in the Word. Stop every once in a while and just say, do I still feel the tug of the anchor? You need to feel that security. There's going to be times when the wind's going to be blowing and the rain is going to be falling and the waves are going to be high. But if you've got your anchor dropped, you're going to feel that stability. The last place you need to drop your anchor is in prayer. If the only time we pray is in the house of God, we're lacking a lot. You have to have time with God alone. There's a book that I've been reading. It's called The Nautical Hour. And it told before the days of satellite guidance systems, the navigators of the ships could only determine what their position was by the constellations and the stars. But in order to know in what direction, they needed to have light. So there is an hour called the nautical hour before daybreak, right before daybreak. And that's a crucial hour because you've got to determine your position and your direction. Prayer is the only place that you will determine your position, know where you really are, and know where you're headed. You have to have the guidance from heaven to know your position, but you need to talk to Him to get your direction. Don't wait till trouble hits, but seek Him early. Be anchored in prayer. In saying that, I want to read a poem tonight. It's The Anchor Holds. The thunder stomped across the sky with angry fists. The rain did beat. My little ship was buffeted so I thought I'd sink into the deep. My ship was lifted on high waves, then slammed into an angry sea. As gusts of wind so fiercely blew, I thought dry land I'd never see. And then a voice called out to me, so calm and clear, though the storm raged. Be not afraid, the anchor holds. It's settled deep beneath the waves. Allow yourself to rest in me. I am the anchor, do not fear. Together we will go through this storm and come into waters calm and clear. And so I took him at his word, though weary, tempest tossed and worn. My ship, though buffeted, was secure. The anchor's strength outweighed the storm. Do not forget, the anchor's strength will outweigh any storm. There's a little course, and I'm probably not going to say it, but it says, I'm anchored in Jesus, the storms of life I'll brave. I've anchored in Jesus, I fear no wind or wave. I've anchored in Jesus, for he hath power to save. I've anchored to the rock of ages. If you will drop your anchors tonight, every day, check and see if you feel that tug of the anchor. God can keep you in any storm. In closing, I'd like to ask the church family and their families to remember every once in a while, let's go to our two senior girls and let's just ask them, do you feel the tug of the anchor? Do you still feel it? You've got to keep your anchor down on the rock of ages. I would like to ask the two girls to come tonight. I wanted to get them something. If you will come over here. I want them to remember they must anchor in the rock of ages. The scripture says, anchor, trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not to your own understanding. Proverbs 3 and 5. Church family, let's remember to help these girls keep their anchor. Anchor yourself in every part of your godly life, and the Lord will keep you through the storms. Thank you.
Taught me in the first grade. That tells you how long she's been around. We're going to give the students their diplomas in a moment. May I ask everyone in the room who is a current or past staff member in any way at Lighthouse Christian Academy to please stand and be recognized. We thank you so much. You may be seated. A few weeks ago, part of the work I do in times where the state requires me to access very confidential information. There's a state computer database that I have access to. I have to be very careful that I maintain proper security at all times. And one of the things that I have to do periodically is answer security questions. And one of them that I could choose from is, who was your favorite teacher? And I knew not to select that one because so many hundreds of people all over Arkansas know that Sister Carolyn T was the favorite teacher I ever had. I love her and thank her for coming tonight. Appreciate all she did for me many, many years ago. A student came up to me not too long ago and named someone else in this room and told me that's the most favorite teacher I ever had, and I had been taught by Sister Janice Faust for a number of years. We've been blessed through the years to have extremely dedicated and faithful teachers. And we love you past and present and future. Thank you again for all you do. The first junior high school diploma goes to April Leanne Floyd. Junior high school diploma, Isaac Harold Edgen. Junior high school diploma, Catalina Jewel Skaggs. Parents and families, thank you for sharing your kids with us at Lighthouse Christian Academy. It's a tremendous investment of your time to do so, and we honor you and appreciate all you've done to invest in those we celebrate tonight. High school diploma, Angelica Church. High
microphone. Catherine Janelle Crawford. Thank you for all you have done in our past. Thank you that you hold our present and our futures in the palm of your holy hand. Bless each and every one of us, Lord, and let us feel the tug of the anchor forevermore. At the end of this race, may we all hear you say, well done. In Jesus' name, we pray. And everyone said amen. Amen. Have a wonderful evening. God bless you all. Feel free to visit with the graduates in the foyer. You're dismissed in Jesus' name.